Hi, and welcome to the Computer Chronicles. I'm Stuart Chaffee. Within the past few years, personal computers have become music machines, driven largely by the development of the MP3 format. But there's a lot more to music and PCs than just MP3. With today's fast processors, 10-gig hard drives, and recordable CD-ROM drives, your PC can become a complete music studio. One of the cool things anyone can do right now is press your own music CDs and carry around only the music you really want to hear. One way to do that is with a piece of software called the Easy CD Creator. And here to show it to us is Mary Eaves of Adaptec. Hi, Mary.
Hi, Stuart.
A couple of basics let's go through first of all. Okay. There are actually different media you can use, right? And I want you to explain the difference. We've got them both right here. This is CDR.
That's
right. This is CDRW. And what is the difference?
CDRW is rewritable media. You can write on it, erase it, write on it again, over and over.
Kind of like a floppy.
A lot like a floppy.
Okay.
CDR media is write-once media. And this is the type of CD that you want to have if you're putting music onto a CD. Because CDRW media won't play on most home
different standards issuing problems here.
Right.
Okay,
right.
So it is you want to do the record once.
That's right.
Gotcha. All right, and let's explain the hardware setup we have over here. You've got your laptop, and you're playing your music CD in the CD drive here.
That's right.
And we're going to record right now on our CD writer
That's
over
correct.
Here. All right, let's take a look at the software now. How do I begin the process of creating my own CD?
Well, when you launch Easy CD Creator, you'll see a screen like this. This is our main project selector screen. Easy CD Creator allows you to make audio CDs, data CDs, photo and video CDs.
Gotcha. All right, so I have a music CD, and I want to pull the cuts I like and put it on my own CD.
So we'd launch the Easy CD Creator audio layout. I have a CD in my CD-ROM drive.
What CD do we have in there?
It's a Red Hot Chili Peppers CD.
Now, where did you get the titles of the songs from?
That's one of the really cool new features we have in this version. We have access to a music database on the internet. It's called the CDDB database.
Right.
And when you put the CD in the CD-ROM drive and hit the, there's a button that's, hit this internet button.
Okay, so I go off to the web, it's got this huge database,
right.
And it gives me the alpha text of all the cuts that are on
That's
there.
That's exactly right.
All right, so I know what's on the CD now. Now, pick the cuts you like and make your favorite,
right.
your Mary's Chili Peppers.
It's really easy to do. I select the tracks that I want, I drag them onto the layout.
So they're the ones you want to copy over to your
exactly.
CDR.
Then I can change the order of them. I can add an audio effect like a crossfade or a fade in or fade out.
All right, so you can do crossfades between cuts as you go from cut one to cut
That's
two
exactly
or
right.
whatever, or put silence in between or whatever
That's
you
right.
want to do.
Okay. It's very easy to do. I selected the track, selected the audio effects option, and then I check the crossfade button and just adjust the length of time that I want the fade to be between the tracks. Once that's done, you see the time indicated there.
And then you say do it.
And then I hit the create CD button.
Go take a walk and come back and you got it.
Exactly.
Is it real time?
Well, it depends on the speed, the extraction speed of your CD-ROM drive and the record speed of your CD writer.
So it could be slower than real time, you're saying?
It could be slower than real time.
Got it. All right, let's talk about something else which is really cool you have in here called Spin Doctor.
That's right.
Which, in fact, lets you take analog music sources and also put them on your
CD.
That's
right. Spin Doctor is a really great tool for getting those old LPs that are collecting dust in your garage onto digital CDs that you can carry around with you and play in your car.
Okay.
It's very simple to use. You connect your turntable to your sound card.
So just plug your audio jacks in here, the normal thing. But you've got, I mean, these LPs are kind of noisy and scratchy. They don't sound as good as the CDs. Can you clean those things
up? We do. We have some filters that allow you to do that.
Can you show us what that
sure.
is?
Okay. This is a recording options dialog.
Okay.
You select the filters that you want.
So go to anti-scratch.
That's right. This one removes the pops and clicks and the hiss from the from the albums. This one allows you to add some morphing effects. I'm going to turn that one off.
Okay.
And then you just hit OK.
Yeah. All right. Finally, you have a very cool utility in here called Jewel Case Creator, because you make your little CDs, and then you want to put them in a nice jewel case with a label. You can actually do that in
here, right? That's
right. Real quick, show us how.
This is the Jewel Case Creator. There's an ability to transfer the title information from the CD in your drive to the jewel
jacket.
Okay,
it's like a real thing. I have to get the titles in there.
Right, you can see them here.
And you created that cover art?
This is actually a template that comes with the product. There are about a dozen or so to choose from for different types of CDs that you might be making. There's a really cute data one.
And you can actually make the label for the CD itself?
Right.
There it is.
Here's
All right, let me just show what the finished product looks like, and if we can get a shot of that. This is actually a little cover art you just made right there. And if you go inside on the CD itself, there's the one you did. Very cool. And finally, what's the software called again?
Easy CD Creator 4 Deluxe.
Mary, thank you very much.
Thank you, Stuart.